Hello, everyone. My name is Prophetess Chanel, and I just want to welcome you to the Voice of the Prophet YouTube channel. If this is your first time joining, welcome and thank you for joining. And if you are a returning subscriber, thank you for being a part of our community, our family, or whatever you want to call it. So on this channel, this is where I release the word that the Lord has given me concerning peoples, nations, his church, whatever it is that he places on my heart. This is where I release the words that he gives me. And so on today, I'm going to talk to you about something that God placed on my heart, and he was referring to the outpouring. And so when he gave me this word, I wasn't sure about what type of outpouring he was speaking specifically of, because we know that in the book of Joel chapter 2, there was prophesied that he was going to pour out his spirit upon all flesh, and his sons and daughters would prophesy. And we saw that manifest in the book of Acts chapter 2 with the day of Pentecost. And so I began to ask the Lord what type of outpouring, because I truly believe that there are different types of outpouring, and I believe that there is going to be an outpouring of God's spirit, of his glory. The glory of God is going to come in a way that we have not seen before, where we're going to see manifested signs, wonders, and miracles take place in his body. But this type of outpouring is not the type of outpouring that we're going to be talking about today. So as we begin to really pray into it, the Lord began to reveal to me what he was speaking of. And so we're just going to get right into it. And it says this: the Lord says he is about to send a fresh outpouring of his spirit throughout the earth. The purpose of this outpouring is to produce a supernatural drawing of the hearts of men. So this is the spirit of God, where he pours out his spirit and he draw all men unto him. And so he began to really truly speak to me, and I began to question him about, because we know that we've been given the great commission to go out into all the earth and to make disciples of men. But he began to truly show me that there is another piece of the Holy Ghost work, even within our evangelizing, that there's a piece of where God has to draw that soul unto him. He has to unlock the heart of that individual for them to be receptive. The Bible also talks about that those whom the Father gave to the Son, he will not lose one. And so we know that God is the one who seeks after man. Man does not seek after God. It's God that seeks after him. Man would not have any reason to know God or to pursue after him unless the Spirit of God draw him to him. And so there have been many evangelists working in the vineyard producing what seems like little results over the years, and especially I would say over the past few years. You know, there's been such a release of the Antichrist spirit in the earth, and many evangelists may feel very much discouraged, to where, you know, we are waiting on that revival. Like many people say, you know, they're waiting on the revival and the outpouring, you know, of God to come and for the great harvest that we've heard prophesied for years and years. But the Lord begins to really show me that there is a set time, and there's a set season for that harvest. And so we're planning, but then there's a set time for that growth to come. And he says what he's about to do, he's about to release his spirit, and it's going to be supernatural working. It's going to be that God, it's God's work that he is going to do, that in this time they will be willing and ready to receive the good news. So it is the place of God working on their heart, God drawing them by his spirit, making them more vulnerable, making them more receptive, opening up their eyes to see. For many times the enemy will come and to blind them and put a veil in their eyes, to where even when we come and we evangelize to them, they can't see, they can't hear, they can't receive. Their hearts are so hard that they're not receptive. But God, by his supernatural power and his strange works and his strange acts, is coming to soften the hearts, pour out his spirit, casting the net out, so that when we go out in the vineyard, we are going to get a good and great, we're coming up with a great harvest, even as Peter did. So he says this: don't be surprised if family members who were once disinterested before seek you out to learn more about God and salvation. It is God's inner work that he is doing. It is God's inner work. We have to remember that some plant, some water, but God is the one that brings forth the increase. The outpouring is coming. Get your nets ready. for the harvest. So as many of you have been toiling, do not become discouraged. As many of you have been doing the work of the evangelist, as many of you have been doing the great commission and call that God has set, I want to let you know, even those of you have been praying for family members, you have been praying for loved ones, you have been praying for those around you who it seems like you've been praying for years and years, and yet there's still the hardness there. There's still, you know, that non-receptive. They don't want to hear, you know, they don't want to hear you preaching. They don't want to hear anything about the word. But I'm telling you, the Lord said he's outpouring his spirit. He is drawing the men unto him. He is the one who is doing the work in their hearts. He is coming, and what was hard before, he's making it a lot more easier. He's making the work easier for us. And it's all for his glory. It's all for his glory. It's all to see the souls come to him. It's all for, you know, the kingdom to be expanded. It's all for God's glory, his purpose. For the whole point is to redeem man. Yes, there's going to be supernatural working, sign, wonders, and miracles. People being healed, you know, gifts manifested, prophecies coming to pass. But we got to remember what the whole point of this whole thing is with Jesus coming is to redeem man back to him, back to our Heavenly Father. And so this is what God is concerned about, the souls. And he said he's coming to draw them. He's coming to draw them back to him. And so this is the scripture that he gave me. He gave me John 6:44, and it says this: "For no one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws them to me." And that's the word. That's the word that I'm speaking. That even in this scripture beforehand, that they were questioning, and they want to know, well, if you're Jesus, you know, show us a sign. And he says this: listen, don't argue, don't fret, don't fuss about this. When you see them, you know, not being, you know, receptive, listen, don't worry. Don't be disheartened, for no one can come. Yes, go evangelize. Yes, spread the good news. But remember, no one can come to me unless the Father who sent them, who sent me, draws them to me. There must be a drawing of his spirit for them to come. And at the last day, I will raise them up. And that is John 6:44. And so that's the word that the Lord gave me. And so, people of God, be blessed, be encouraged, continue to do the work that he gave for us to do. Continue to pray for those unsaved loved ones, for those who have backslidden, because we are going to see God work. We are going to see him move in a supernatural way. It may surprise you in a place where you're like, what happened? They're going to be on fire for God. They're going to want to know more about God. And it's all because his spirit is doing the work. So be still, know that God is doing the work in this thing. And after all of this, he's going to get the glory. Amen. So people of God, be blessed and have a great day.